Hello there and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video we're going to be taking a look at Guillotine, about what kind of fun and interesting things she can do and whether it's actually viable to use her as one of our regular questing champions based on her damage output. But if you're wondering what the hell just happened in that video, how did a 2-star deal 300k special 3, then do stay tuned and I'll explain all that. Thing about Guillotine is she works with souls. Basically every 6% of damage we deal to opponent, we gain a soul. One soul expires every 10 seconds. Now, next important thing to note about Guillotine is her level 3 deals 2% flat damage of opponent's max health to opponent per soul upon the time of activation, regardless of how big of the health pool opponent has. So the more souls, the more percentage of damage we're going to be doing. As an example, 10 souls, we launch special 3, it's going to deal 20% damage to any opponent. The synergies that make it possible with 2-star Guillotine, number one is Morningstar. Morningstar makes sure our souls expire every 20 seconds instead of every 10 seconds. And the second important synergy is Gamora. Gamora basically lets us get a soul every 10 seconds so long as opponent is bleeding. And so it works against every single champion we can bleed. We're going to be getting an extra soul every 20 seconds. The third synergy which we are using is Night Thresher one. It helps us with our overall damage output because it increases our critical rating based on the number of souls we have, but it does not need to be used for this special 3 trick. It is extremely handy using Guillotine in general questing though. So I have sped up this 2-star Guillotine fight I think 5 or 6 times because it is going to take us a while to get a decent number of souls. I believe we're going to get to about 600 hits, but meanwhile let me explain how this works. So as I said before, Guillotine works with her souls and all her abilities get more potent the more souls she has, and every 10 seconds basically one of her souls expires and she loses it. However, every 6% of health we deal to opponent, we gain one. However, with that 2-star, fighting such large opponent, that practically helps us not at all. we're not dealing him nearly enough damage for that to be reliable sorts of souls. The way we are building up souls in this fight, for most part, is the Morningstar and Gamora synergies. Because of Morningstar, our souls expire only every 20 seconds, and because of Gamora, we're getting a soul pretty much every 10 seconds of that synergy. So every 20 seconds that we spend in the fight, we basically gain a soul, plus then here and there any additional ones once we kind of hit the 6% mark on the opponent. But the point of fighting with Guillotine over here is that we do need to spend some time in the fight to build up these souls. If we're using stronger Guillotine against lesser health opponents, obviously then it's much quicker and much easier, but even a 2-star, thanks to these two synergies, can build up pretty much indefinite amount of souls. And then once we have gotten enough souls to pretty much wipe out opponents' remaining health pool, we're going to be shooting a level 3. And as we saw at the beginning of the video, I believe we're going to be getting about 300k special 3 out of a 2-star Guillotine. And the thing is, irony is, this also could work in LoL if not for the damage cap, but unfortunately because of the 50k damage cap which this special attack does not get by, it doesn't. However, it does work in Realm of Legends and pretty much every other content. As we just saw, he took 300k, 296k special 3 from a 2-star. That's quite fun and impressive. But anyways, that's not the main thing this video is about. This video is more so about what is actual Guillotine's damage output, combining these three synergies with Night Thresher and just kind of checking her out. So now we're going to be taking a bit more realistic scenario of our rank 4 5-star Guillotine going in the fight against Winter Soldier. It is worth mentioning that, as you saw, even a 2-star Guillotine kept the health pool up to the max thanks to her healing, and her healing gets more potent the more souls we have. So Gilly actually turns into quite a reliable healing champion that's extremely good for sustainability in the quest. But first, let's take a look at her damage output. As we see here, we're still going to be launching special attacks and still healing quite considerably, so our health isn't going to be going down at all, so she's extremely suicide friendly. But let's just see how often do we start to crit thanks to Dark Oak synergy. sorry, not Darkhawk, Night Racer synergy, because for every soul we get 100 critical rating. So before soon we're going to be critting much more often than not, and that's quite insane, especially for longer kind of fights where we manage to keep souls up. One thing I have to mention is that before you're ready to launch a special 3, stick to special 1s, because that does not consume any souls. Special 2 will cost you 2 souls. So if you do somehow end up pushing past 2 bars of power, just do not shoot it and just keep your special to yourself. Essentially, special 1 isn't important. You could completely skip shooting it either way. It's just kind of a tiny bit of extra damage. But yeah, so we're gonna see here we're on 82 hits. Winter Soldier is about halfway through. So, and how many hits is it gonna take for this Guillotine to down Winter Soldier as a rank 4 5 star? So I think we're about ready to launch our special 3. So it's like 97, 99 hits, and we're launching our special 3. So and that's pretty much gonna kill him, I believe. So a rank 4 5 star taking down 500k Winter Soldier in 100 hits. I do not think that's bad at all. I think it's somewhere up there. I do know that I'm running suicides and all, but Guillotine covers the suicide damage so well that I do not even consider that to be a minus. And yeah, it was exactly 100 hits, I believe. And now we're going to take a look at a 4 star rank 4 Guillotine in Uncollected. So not even a maxed out 4 star, and let's see how she does. Sorry, there's a battery popper damage. But yeah, basically, so we're running still the same 3 synergies. Morningstar synergy is not even really needed, kind of like in general questing. It's just the Gamora one that lets her get souls a lot more aggressive. And the Night Thresher one that increases her critical damage. Those are the main two. If you would have to pick a main one, that would be the Night Thresher for general questing. But yeah, we're gonna see. So we're at 20 hits against this Spidey, and yeah, we're pretty much healed up back again due to her abilities. 25 hits, and don't think there's much left in him. Don't think we're even gonna bother with our level 3 in here. Oh, we did, but that was like a formality. So 30 hits takes down a 15k symbiote Spidey in Uncollected difficulty. A rank 4 4 star. So anyways, I do think that is quite impressive damage output, and if you do happen to have like a 6 star Gamora you enjoy questing with, it's definitely kind of worth checking out this synergy team and perhaps using it as your questing team while your main players are in AQ or AW, because she definitely puts out some solid numbers. So obviously I'm not going to be using her against this Human Torch because she's a mystic. But aside from that, I'm just gonna let a couple more fights play out in the background. I do hope you guys enjoyed the video. I do hope you guys have some fun, perhaps putting out some massive numbers with your 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, or whatever guillotines you have. And I do hope you also have some fun with her, like as a general questing champion. And yeah, I think that's about it for me. I'm gonna leave the rest of the fights in the background, as I said. If you did enjoy the video, please do feel free to leave that like, hit that sub button, share it with your alliance, share the channel with your friends and alliance, and I'm hopefully gonna see you guys very soon.